Welcome back to Let's Play Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari and I'm excited because I believe we're going to a new area finally, Hollywood.
Need a ride?
Okay, get me out of here. Oh, Grout's Mansion? Maybe we're just going to Grout's Mansion. I don't think the map scrolls around. Grout's Mansion. Oh yeah, yeah, he's the Nosferatu looking for.
You! What are you doing here?
Yo, Nines! What's up?
Out now.
Feeling all right, man?
You should get out of here. This place is bad news. Pardon me.
Second choice. Why? What's inside? I can't. You encountered Nines at Grout's Mansion, and he seemed a bit out of sorts. Well, it doesn't exactly fill me with confidence, of course. Guess the music is cheerful enough. Nothing interesting outside. Oh, okay. That leaf just appeared out of nowhere. Should I be sneaking then? I don't know. Blood shield. Having that ready. Is this... what's this over here? Oh. Just a random rat to feed on if we need a top off, which we do not. Didn't seem very happy to see us either, Rodriguez. What the hell was she wearing on her face? It's gonna be like that, is it? Log updated. You just encountered Grout's Mansion and something about it didn't feel quite right. Yeah, no kidding. People are all insane. Yeah. Can't even try that. Is that Grout?
Another unfortunate casualty to Tide of Time, insane asylums. I lament their loss not only as brokerage houses for the breadth and depth of human psychoses, but also I shall mourn the disappearance of that peculiar environment present only in an insane asylum. That palpable atmosphere of blistered brains and churning bowels, the odoriferous mélange of freely flowing bodily humors, that gently rolling cacophony of distant sobs and screams, the muttered cursing at perceived enemies, and the blissful gurgling of the lobotomized, like a newborn babe discovering the sky. I shall still find test subjects as surely as I find bloody sustenance in the night, but this climate, I fear, may never be replicated.
Is that Grout? I have a feeling that might be Grout, so before I... It doesn't even give me the lock sound. Before I even go there, let's see what's down these other areas. So we've got that. Oh, we've got something else here.
It is quite peculiar, the happenings I've been made to witness for my supernatural longevity. I am thinking of one unfortunate phenomenon in particular, of unique interest to my station, both as a professional and as a sufferer of this vampiric condition. It seems the stream of time has begun to erode the moorings of my chosen course of study, for the methodologies that gave birth to psychology are slowly disappearing. I find myself in an era that overlooks the physical component of psychological pathology time and again in favor of the sophistic practices of Freud. Phrenology, dactopintalism, and the rest of the old guard has fallen by the wayside, its champions all silenced in death, with my unique exception. Would that I could make my voice heard again, although it may be suspicious should I return to popular medical discourse 50 years after my apparent death. No, better that I continue my studies into the psychoses in secret. One day, may I hold up my own cure as validation of the methods. I am confident no cure for my condition or that of my beloved wife lies within our figurative minds, waiting to be unlocked by the correct combination of memories recovered from our childhoods. And I'm most certain it has nothing to do with the relationship between myself, my parents, and my genitals. Sorry, Sigmund, but I choose to stay my course. In time, too, may your star fade and disappear.
So apparently that's what he's doing here. Research? That's locked. is. I can't open that. Perception at once shapes the mind and rules over time. Time, however, erodes human perception and then in turn warps the mind. The mind is capricious, having various effects on perception, time, and the mind itself. With harmony, progress is made. I've gained an unknown item. Weakapog Thistle. Oh, is this what, No, it's a fetish in a museum. This petrified reed was not meant to fall into the hands of the damned, but vampires can benefit from its shamanistic magic all the same. Increases defense by 1 point. Oh. I guess just having it? Defense. Defense as in a feat? Combat defense 7. Right. So I've got 3 in dodge, 3 in wits, and then 1 with this thistle. Awesome. Can never have too much defense. Greetings. Am I supposed to kill this guy to continue then? Is that one? Oh, wait. I can pull that one. And this one. Ah, twice. Doing it at once. Okay. That opens up that area. Solved Grout's riddle. What if I pull this at the same time? I'm sneaking now because that's opened and those other ones can get out. Well, that was handy that he was doing that. So this still locked. This inaccessible. Guess someone's decided to pile all that crap there. Through the door, good. You just go, ow. Can't open doors by yourself? You are insane. I didn't realize there was a second one there. Locking the door. Too bad you can't pick up multiple knives. I'd love to sell all these. Did I interrupt the no, I think I got that. Because I am full. Stairs go anywhere? Looks pretty eviscerated. Nope. Sounds like there are people up here, but the stairs doesn't go to them. So three doors. I was looking for more listening devices. At least that one has the courtesy to make the locked sound. Not like that other door. I don't suppose I have to pull this. Oh. Are there any other that pulled something where I have not been yet? I don't see any others to pull, okay. Oh, they're all locked. Oh, I see. Let me make sure this is locked too, just in case. Sure is. I still have this. I don't. I don't have blood shield on. I think I missed that one. I think I shot her. I chose to not get hit. There's his arm chopped right off. Thank you.
Often I reflect with great regret on the missed opportunity that was my infector. Had I been conscious after the attack, I could have stopped the orderlies from locking her in the roaming pen. What I would give for just one interview, a few simple questions of the plague-ridden woman who met her end that dawn. Of course, there is no guarantee she would have been any more helpful than my current crop of test subjects, mewling wretches. Few could be called enthusiastic. Given the nature of the tests, I cannot expect the same fervor from all, but a modicum of cooperation would be appreciated. Animals. The one called John went so far as to gnaw off his arm and escape into the floorboards like some feral rodent. I still hear him scurrying about at night. He must be making an atrocious mess in there.
John, huh? We're gonna meet this John. Person dead? No target.
My studies proceed at a languid pace. I'm mired in a foul ennui as my wife's illness advances. My subjects grow restless without proper supervision, but I cannot pull myself back from this black depression. How many nights I've wasted now, gazing from the tower walk, pondering the frailty of existence.
So that's why he did not answer the Camarilla's call? Too depressed? The futility of all and stuff like that? Basically two aspects is used for basically nothing. What's one more, right? For a little bit. Now we're going back down. Perhaps he was the architect of this place as well. A madman in more than one sense of the word. He's swinging it. Same kind of dagger? Someone just beyond the door there. Oh, wrong thing. Damn it. They are insane. Should be at least one more. No? One there. So we got several small corridors with doors, and we got a door at the end. Any more listening devices? We've got a corpse here. Looking for anything to turn, no? Candelabras. See? Doesn't make any sound. I want to hear that little click click. Don't know why, but I do. Hear that owl? I can just barely hear it. All this comes out here. Alright. Where were we? Did I check this one? Pardon me, guys. Sorry. I got turned around, I guess. So I came from there. That goes back. So then this is probably one of the other doors that goes back into that room. Yep. So then here should be something new. I know, I save a lot. Another listening device. Two more of these people. Using some ammo here. My reflection! Let me guess, we're gonna go in there somehow. Oh, I can see them through here. That's not a mirror, it's a window?
After decades of solitary study into this affliction, I have learned that it is by no means mine alone. Indeed, the city is home to an entire society of similarly afflicted individuals with whom I've only recently made contact. They are an understandably standoffish sort, by and large, but I have been able to confirm with them that the condition is indeed vampirism, which apparently comes in a multitude of strains, each with a spectacular set of symptoms such as invisibility and even a sort of lycanthropy. Through numerous official interactions with the governing body of this secret society,
Andrew,
I have concluded that their fundamental understanding of the vampiric condition is woefully lacking and mired in suspicion and pseudo-religious dogma that would make a Turk balk for its strictures. Indeed, they seemed impressed with my studies and the eloquence with which I was able to present them. Apparently, the typical sufferer of my particular strain of vampirism is far from the vanguard of the King's English. So impressed were they that they even offered me an office in their government, a rather high office by the sound of things, I believe I shall accept. If nothing else, it should provide a lofty vantage point from which to observe the breadth and epidemiology of the affliction so that I may move more expeditiously toward a cure.
And that's how he became the Malkavian. I forget what they call it. Ambassador, for quite, for lack of a better term at the moment. See, I thought we were in Hollywood, but I guess we're one place in Hollywood. Now, my question is, I can see these people. This is a window, apparently. Can't target them. Can I open this? How do I open this? How do I advance further? Wait. Oh, I pressed those. Oh, got it.